ticket for an aeroplane. Hi guys, JB Minot here, and these are my pickups for July 2018. I haven't done a video in a while, but that's okay. Hopefully this one will be exciting. We'll see. Okay, the first one, it's mostly Switch games, but I'm going to go ahead and show off some of the NES games I got. Wrath of the Black Manta. It's a ninja fighting game. I didn't know they made a movie off, or a game off this movie. Mad Max. It's a car battler game. You know what? To be truthfully honest, most of Mad Max, I don't think really holds up today. There really wasn't as much action in there as you'd think it was. The best of the series, franchise series, would be the Road Warrior and the newer Mad Max, Mad Max Fury Road. Those are pretty good. And a final fight game or Double Dragon type game, Renegade. That brings my NES collection up to 161. So we'll see where it goes from there. Now for my Switch games. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 Switch games this month. I don't know how I managed it, but this first one is an action RPG from Sega. Shining Resonance Refrain. Draconic Launch Edition. It's got a steel book with the game. It's not getting very good reviews. It looks kind of derivative from what I've seen, but it's from Sega, and people love their Sega games for some reason. I really don't care for a lot of Sega RPGs because they're all kind of the same to me. But this game's actually been out for a couple of years, but they finally came out with a physical edition, and it's actually gotten really, really, really kick-ass reviews for once in a Sonic game. Sonic Mania Plus. And here you have all this. Maybe I should go ahead and unbox. Let me see what it's got in here. Let's see. Go ahead and open and break the seal. If I can do it without breaking the whole thing here. Okay, we got that. And it comes with this thing. And it comes with a art book. Just a bunch of drawings from the Sonic universe. And that's about it. They came standard, so. And of course you have the game itself, which they say is really kick-ass. We'll find out. Sometimes Sonic games, I like Sonic games, but it's one of those things that I kind of suck at them. But we'll see. Okay, this is one of the best games on the Switch. I love this game. It's a mixture between Dig Dug and Metroidvania games. It's SteamWorld Dig 2. I'd love to see a physical version of SteamWorld Dig on the Switch 2. But basically, you're this guy and you're going around to these different caves, or these different areas, and you're digging. You're trying to find your best friend. And you're using your digging powers. And as you go along, you get different powers to help you out. You get bombs. You get more powerful drills. You get the ability to jump higher. Stuff like that. It's kind of like a Metroidvania game. The only real problem I have with this game is it's kind of short. There's only like three or four bosses in the game itself. But the exploration and to go back and find all the secrets, and there are secret areas, is just fantastic. If you like Metroid, you'll definitely love this game. I can't recommend it enough. It only cost me $30, brand new. So, okay, Go Vacation. They say this is kind of like Pilot Wings, and what's that one game that was released on the Wii? Wii Sports or something like that. But it's a bunch of different sports games. They say it's got a bunch of exploration games. But a lot of exploration, different resorts, and there are 50 games, and they're kind of easy once you start, but it's kind of derivative so far. I haven't played much into it because I've been playing another game, which I'll talk about later on. Okay, this game is really, really charming. It's like a, I guess Shaquille O'Neal had a game on the Super NES a long time ago called Shaq Fu. I don't know how popular that was. As far as I know, it wasn't very popular, but we'll see. But Shaq Fu, A Legend Reborn. And this is like a, this is kind of a Double Dragon type game. It's a fighter game where you're just going from one side of the screen to the other, beating up bad guys. And as you get more power, as you gain more powers, you get more powerful as the game goes along. But what's really great about this game is the absolute charm. It's actually got some funny dialogue in it, which I'm not big on dialogue or story, but the story really enhances this game. It's really fun. It's a blast to play. Maybe get it for a lower budget, but I got this one for less than 30 bucks. But there's that. Because I got the Elite Pro still for GameStop, which they discontinued as of Wednesday. They discontinued it. But I still get it till I think May of next year. And the Elite Pro really kind of pays for itself. I've got many games on a discount because of it. Okay, an RPG, haven't played it yet, called The Lost Child from NIS. I can't recall the reviews for this game. It's gotten okay reviews. I bought this game for 10 bucks, part of a series, Snow Moto Racing Freedom. I think this one's gotten gotten better reviews than the Aqua one. Haven't gotten that one yet, but I might get that one later on, though, much later on down the line when it's cheaper. But they're like 19 bucks new, but I got that one for 10 bucks. Okay. Captain Toad Treasure Tracker, which was one of the best games on the Wii U. I went and traded it in for this, and this game is an excellent puzzler. It's basically a bunch of little mini platforms, and what you have to do is you have to collect. I can't remember. It's been a while since I played. You got to collect certain items to solve the puzzle, but you can turn the island around and you can climb on things and. It's all thought for the most part, but it's a blast to play. It's fun. Just a great puzzle game. Great brain twisters. Okay. I also traded this one in, because this is one of the best games on the Wii U. Hyrule Warriors Definitive Edition. This is a blast to play. It's like Dynasty Warriors, only with Zelda characters. And it's just... beautiful, fun game to play. Absolute blast. If you like Dynasty Warriors, if you like Legend of Zelda, you can't go wrong with this game. It's an excellent fighting game. It'll keep you occupied for hours and hours. It's a blast to play. Okay, this is based on the anime Attack on Titan. This is Attack on Titan 2. I gotta be honest with you, I can't stand Attack on Titan. I'm not as much into anime as I used to be. I love good anime when it's not derivative, when it's not the same old, but I really hate the Attack on Titan anime because all the characters are supposed to be soldiers and they're so freaking whiny all the time. It's no fun. But I've seen the footage of this game and I've heard about it and the gameplay on this game looks really, really, really fun. So we'll see. You know, I'm not going to judge a game because I don't like the anime. I know a lot of people love the anime, but I don't. Okay, this looks like to be a rogue action RPG. Tohu Ginso Wanderer Reloaded. There's that. And it's some kind of RPG. I think it's a rogue playing RPG where you go into a dungeon and it changes shapes and enemies every time you go into it. Those games I'm usually not very good at, but I like playing them, though. Okay, this game is based on an old PC game, I think, called Titan Quest. It's kind of a Diablo clone, and apparently people who play the game really, really like it. The gameplay is really good. The problem people have with it is that it isn't changed much from the 2006 edition. It's a 12-year-old game, but it's really... they charge 40 bucks for it, and whether it's worth it or not, I don't know. Maybe that they charged a little less for it, but they say there's no extra bells or whistles than from the original. So, and the graphics are pretty much the same. This is how you do a collection game. I know you heard, I don't know if you've heard about the controversy about Spyro, how they They have a Spyro collection, but what it is you only you get one game and you have to download the other two games. That's not a collection. That's the first game and downloading two other games. That's not a collection. And Capcom does it too with their Mega Man collections. You got Mega Man and you got Mega Man X collections. And the Mega Man and the Mega Man X collections, you got the first half of the series on each disc. But in small, tiny little print, they say, nope, you got to download the second half of the franchise. And that's bogus. Okay, release them maybe separately on different discs or on different cartridges or what have you. But don't treat people like that. This is how you do it right. There are actually three original games on this game, which is funny. It's from Activision. The same guy's doing the Spyro. But Crash Bandicoot, Insane Trilogy. Haven't played it yet, but the fact that they've actually got the three games on there, and you don't have to download the other two games. You got actually three games instead of just one game and then downloading the other two, and then they're telling you at the bottom of the box here in tiny print. That's bullshit. But this game's getting good reviews. I can't wait to play it. But right now, and last but not least, I'm obsessed with another game. It's called, and this game, they didn't expect it to sell out. Why other people like it, I don't know. I like it. Octopath Traveler. It kind of looks like a 16-bit game, but the graphics are gorgeous, but that's not why I enjoy this game. I never enjoy a game just because of the graphics. And the story, I could do without the stories. There's like eight different stories that kind of interchange a little bit. Not very much. But, you can play eight different stories in this game. You start off with one person, and she's the main character. I start off with the cleric. And each chapter, you can play different chapters of each character. And it's just a great game. The battle system is what shines on here. In the battle system, you can't just hit attack, attack, attack. No. What you have to do is you have to figure out the vulnerability of each monster that you're fighting. And until you figure out that vulnerability, your attack just might mean nothing. But once you figure out those vulnerabilities, and once you hit him so many times with that vulnerable weapon, and they break, all of a sudden that weapon that was weak before can kill him instantly. And it's just, the battle system is just fantastic. There are better people who do better reviews of this game. This is just a quick... But right now, I'm doing all the chapter 2s of all 8 characters. I don't know how you're supposed to do it. Maybe you're supposed to do like a whole story straight through and go straight from chapter 1 to chapter 2. But what I've been doing is I've been doing all the chapters of each character. I went to chapter 1 of every character. Then I'm going through right now chapter 2 of every character. And I'll tell you what. It is a tough... There are some tough games. Tough boss battles. They're really tough. And they take a while. I've already played the game almost 30 hours, and I don't even know if I've gotten halfway through it. But I still enjoy it, though. But if you like RPGs, old-school RPGs, it's from Square Enix. My only real quibble with this game is that there are random battles. I hate random battles. But the game is beautiful. It's fun to play. The battle system is excellent. It's fun trying to figure out what vulnerabilities each of the enemies have. There are times I could have killed an enemy instantly, but I wanted to figure out what their vulnerabilities were before I did it. And I just, you know, kept the battle going. But it's a blast to play. When you need resources such as magic points and healing points, or potions to heal your magic, potions to heal your body, they're easy to find. They're easy in any town. There's always a town around the corner. It's not so difficult that you can't play it, but it's not the easiest RPG in the world. And it's a blast to play. And I tell you, there are guys out there. Check it out. They didn't think this would sell out, but it's sold out. It's one of the best RPGs. It's definitely the best RPG, I think, on the Switch. And it's exclusively for the Switch. I can't say enough about this game, but I like it. And there it is. Okay, that brings my Switch collection. Let me see how many Switch games I've got. Let me see here. Hold on. That's not what I want. Let's see. How many Switch games I've got? I've got That brings my Switch collection in a little over a year and a half, not even a year and a half, about a year and 3 months, to 83. So, and I've still got a long ways to go. Okay, guys, that's my pickups video for the month of July. Tell me what you think. Don't forget to subscribe, to thumbs up. Don't forget to, you know, if you want to go to my Twitter page, I'll put the link at the end of the video. Anyway, I hope you guys have a great summer. It's going by fast. I hope you had a good 4th of July. And enjoy the rest of your summer. And God bless. Bye-bye.